fish farms off the sea. Take those fish farms off the sea.
Do we want to be the ones who said we were there when the last of our resident orcas were lost? Or will we be the last ones to know what this place was once like? And will we have to answer when our ancestors asked us what we were doing? To let the last of the orcas be lost? To let the last of our wild salmon be lost? That's not a conversation I'm willing to have.
Here!
Wild salmon are one of the power cords that keep our world alive. Wild salmon feed the trees that make the oxygen we breathe. They feed the whales, over 100 species. Their bodies built the soil of British Columbia. You cannot underestimate the value of wild salmon, and yet Canadian government just pretends that the salmon farming industry is somehow so much more important than wild salmon that they can just let it kill the wild salmon off. The whole problem with salmon farms is that they hold animals stationary and they don't allow the predators in. And so it makes it just too easy for disease to spread fish to fish to fish. Over 80% of these farm salmon are infected with piscine reovirus, which is a very tough, durable little virus from Norway, spreads through the water. Recent research has found that when this virus gets into the Chinook salmon, it causes their red blood cells to explode. Viruses are spreading into our wild salmon. The orca are starving for a lack of Chinook salmon. First Nation people have no wild salmon as part of their diet. This was one of the most critical portions of their diet for the last 10,000 years. The scope of the impact of salmon farming is everywhere, from the algae to the orca to the people. The independent scientists in British Columbia are really doing the heavy lifting here. We are providing the science in top scientific journals, but the Canadian government just refuses to acknowledge it. I personally have written over 20 scientific papers on the impact of sea lice and viruses. I turned my home in Echo Bay into a research station, and dozens of papers have been produced now, and the government just won't hear it. The level of denial that the Canadian government is showing around salmon farming makes me wonder what is going on behind the scenes. What is Canada getting out of this? That Canada is allowing the loss of wild salmon. I think the salmon farming industry expects that at some point I'm going to give up. But blocking scientists the access to their fish just means we're going to get more creative in getting that data. Having Sea Shepherd here for 3 summers in a row with the Martin Sheen bringing crew members with specialized skills means that we are going to be able to produce the science that really pins down what this industry is doing to the whales in this coast, and we are not going to give up.